Christian.
Okay, we're going to be talking about how they loaded the cannon and how they turned on different trees.
For two salutes. I'm sorry.
It was the very first battle of the Revolutionary War.
What?
Have you studied the Revolutionary War already in your history classes?
Yeah.
Okay.
The War of Independence.
You know it was the War of Independence. The War of Independence. Okay, well, we're going to learn a little bit about the War of Independence and how it got started by showing you this battle. I need to explain a few things to you so you'll know. When you're doing a reenactment, it's really kind of like pretend, and it's sort of like the play. Those are not real guns. Some of you were asking me. Those are just ones we made out of wood and dowel rods. They can't fire. They are just pretend guns, and they can't shoot anybody. And we wouldn't want to shoot anybody, but we have to, in order to do our play, fire upon each other in this play. But we're not doing it for real, of course. Daniel? Actually, I probably... Well, yes, there will be a noise that sounds like shots. That's just what we call sound effects. And in a few minutes, you'll see them. And over here is the Patriots. And Mrs. Brady's going to have to... Brady's going to have to move because she's on our bridge. That is a bridge, okay? We don't have a very fancy bridge, but that's our bridge, okay? And in a few minutes, you're going to see some boys on horseback. They're going to look a little bit more like bicycles to you. But you just imagine that those are horses they're on, okay? Because we didn't have any horses to bring to our reenactment, so they're using bicycles. All right, Red Coats, are you ready? Okay. Long ago, our country was part of another country called England. We had a king named George. King George and other men in England decided the laws that everyone living here in the colonies must follow. King George also made the colonists pay taxes to help England fight wars with France, Spain, and other countries in Europe. Many of the colonists thought this was unfair. They started holding secret meetings to plan how the colonies could be free of this unfair treatment. People around the countryside of Boston, Lexington, and Concord started to store barrels of gunpowder, muskets, and cannons in people's barns. The British Army under General Thomas Gage found out about these munitions being stored and were ordered by England to destroy them. General Gage planned a secret mission to go to Concord and destroy the munitions. But Patriot spies found out about the plan and spread the word that the British were coming. During the evening of April 18, 1775, the troops in Boston started to prepare for the march to Concord. Someone in the old North Church hung two lanterns in the steeple to signal Paul Revere and William Dawes that the British were coming by boat across the harbor.
British are coming! British are coming!
As the British were marching to Lexington, militiamen from all around Lexington started to gather on the village green. Some got tired of waiting and were told by Captain John Parker to go back home. But returned if they heard the militia drums. Those that lived nearby went home, and others went to Buckman's Tavern next to the green. Then charge the rebels!
apart, so when you see dead people getting up, they didn't come back to life.
In a few short minutes, 8 Americans died and 10 were wounded. One redcoat and Major Pickpan's horse were wounded. After a rousing cheer for their victory, Major Pitcairn and his troops headed for Concord.
March!
Oh, man. little soldiers, the striped tents, and prepare to march. Soldiers rise at daybreak and sentries to weave off chains.